Do you want unlimited possibilities for interacting with your viewers, where the only limit is your imagination? SAMMI is a fully customizable stream deck that lets your live stream viewers on Twitch and YouTube interact with you, and maybe even control your stream. You can do basic stuff like make an OBS source appear and disappear, create your own alerts, toggle the filter of a source on OBS, make your own chatbot, and if you know your way around HTML and JavaScript, you can create very interactive browser sources. Let's go through the basics of SAMMI. You will need OBS. If you have OBS Studio already, go get SAMMI from SAMMI.Solutions. Link is everywhere. Click on this download button, and you'll be brought to this download button. And clicking on this download button will bring you to the download page, and you'll see another download button. Click on this download button, and you'll be brought to their download page on itch. You can click on this link which says, "No thanks, just take me to the downloads," and click the download button of the latest version, and you'll finally be able to download it. But please consider coming back to this page to support the SAMMI team, even if you've already downloaded it. They really deserve it. Damn, I had to rewrite this sentence about downloading since it's gonna be impossible for me to say the whole thing in one go. Whew. Anyway, extract it. Oh my god, not the desktop folder! Go into the x64 folder and launch SAMMI Core. If it's your first time to run SAMMI, you may get a Windows security alert that your firewall is blocking it. You need to give it access for it to be able to communicate with OBS. You may also see a notification that SAMMI was unable to load any decks. Duh. First time. So yes. Now let's connect SAMMI to OBS by clicking on the OBS Connections button here. You'll see some stuff. IP is the address where OBS is and which SAMMI will connect to. 127.0.0.1 is Ultra Hacker lead speak for this computer. Nah, of course not. But I just wanted to say something cool. If you're using OBS 28 and above, you won't need to worry about the protocol and the port. I highly recommend upgrading to 28 now anyway. Don't worry, I also held off of upgrading for months, but finally made the jump. Now for the password. Let's go to your OBS, go to Tools, WebSocket Server Settings. If this is unchecked, you need to enable WebSocket Server for OBS to receive commands from something else. Click on Show Connect Info to see and copy your OBS WebSocket password. Go back to SAMMI and paste this in the password field. You may want to enable auto connect so that if you lose your connection to OBS for whatever reason, like if you close OBS, you won't need to go here to connect it again. Click on this connect button to hopefully see it change into a disconnect button. Also take a look at the lower left where you'll see the main OBS indicator go from red to green. Save and close. Confirm your connection by going back to OBS and looking at the connected WebSocket sessions. Do be careful not to kick yourself. Close this window. Let's start with the basics by creating our own software stream deck. Elgato is expensive, but worth it. If you're not yet familiar with what a stream deck is, it's a panel that has buttons you can press to make your computer do stuff. Wait, isn't that what a keyboard does? Or a gamepad? Yeah! So we're basically creating a software version of this. The most basic use of a Stream Deck is as a scene switcher, so let's do that. Make sure your OBS is open. You'll probably see a vast blue sea of blankness, except for a plus button. Create your first deck by clicking this plus sign and then add new deck. Double-click on this deck to edit it. You can name this and any deck as you wish. Let's name this Test Deck. If this looks Blade Runner or Tron scary, don't worry. You can ignore all of these for now. Create a button by right-clicking anywhere, then create button. You can resize this button however you want, but if you want finer resizing, then you can change the X and Y sizes. Right-click on this button and edit appearance. The display text is basically the label of this button. You can add an image if you want or change the color of the button. If you can't make up your mind, You have the random button for that. God, I love these buttons. Let's name this first scene. Anyway, when you're done, click save. I'm gonna start with a blank scene collection for this tutorial. Add a text source and put something. Create another scene and add a color source or whatever you prefer as long as it's different from the first scene. Go back to SAMMI, right-click on the button, and click Edit Commands or double-click this button. Click on this plus sign, select OBS Commands, then switch scene. Don't worry, you don't have to know where to go to find something. That's what the search box is for. If you are unable to see your scenes and or your sources, it may be because SAMMI doesn't know that you created new scenes and sources after it connected to OBS. You may need to refresh SAMMI's view of OBS stuff by going back to OBS connections, disconnecting, and reconnecting again. Anyway, back to our button. Select your scene, then save and close the button. Next, create a button to switch to a second scene by right-clicking the first button, copy button, then right-click on a blank area and paste button. Rename this button to second scene. Save. Then double-click it to edit the commands. You'll see that it's an exact copy of your previous button. So select your second scene in OBS and save and close this button. Now click Save one more time to save this deck. Let's go test this button. In the main page of SAMMI, click on SAMMI Deck, then click on Open SAMMI Deck. Don't worry about these for now, leave them at default, and just click Connect. Make sure that your selected deck is our newly created deck. Then click Load Deck. Click on your buttons to test them. Nice. Now we're going to make a button to toggle the visibility of a text source in OBS. So create a text source if you don't have one. Go back to SAMMI, create a button. Let's name this Show My Text. Save. Edit the button commands by double-clicking on it. Click on the plus sign, look for visibility, and select Source Change Visibility. If you don't see your source, again, please reconnect SAMMI or just relaunch it. Select your scene, then your source, then check the visible box. Save and close. Next, copy this button, paste it somewhere, and rename it to Hide Your Text. Double-click to edit the commands, but instead of checking the visible checkbox, we'll now disable this to hide the text source. Save and close the button, then save the deck. Open SAMMI Deck again and test your buttons. Voila! Now, as you beautiful people can already probably tell, you can do the same thing and toggle the visibility of any source in OBS. Let's try changing the text of a text source now. Go back to edit your deck, create a new button, name this Hello, save, then double-click to edit its commands. Click on the plus sign, look for text, and select Source Change Text, GDI plus. Select your source and type Hello, save and close. Copy this button, paste it somewhere, and rename it to YouTube. Double-click and change the text to YouTube's. By the way, I've been naming my buttons like an idiot to show you that the button names don't have any connection to what's happening in OBS. These are just for our reference. Open SAMMI Deck, test, and again, voila! Now this tutorial is actually starting to get longer than I think you would want. If you think you like longer tutorials like these, please let me know in the comments. Oh, and please do hit that subscribe button, and that like button, and that share button. Okay, back to business. And by business, I mean let's connect your Twitch account to allow users to interact with your stream. Back on SAMMI's main screen, click on Twitch Connections. Click on Link Streamer Account. If you only have one Twitch account, then all you need to do is to give SAMMI the privileges it requires. This will tell SAMMI to listen to chat, commands, and channel point reward redemptions on the channel that is logged in, where this link opens. In my case, I have my streaming account logged in on my default browser and my bot account in another. If SAMMI launches a browser with the wrong Twitch account, then you can just click Copy Streamer URL and paste it in the browser where your streaming account is logged in, and go from there. I suggest enabling auto connect to Twitch for the same reasons earlier. Once you're done, click done.
Duh.
And SAMMI will tell you that this and that. Close this prompt if you've already connected your Twitch account. Take a look at the connection indicators at the lower left. You'll notice that Twitch PubSub and Twitch Chat have now also lit up green. Now that we're done connecting our Twitch account, let's start working the magic. First, let's do commands. Go back to your deck and right-click on your button which switches to your first OBS scene. This time, select Edit Triggers. Click the plus sign and search for Chat. Select Twitch Chat. In the message field, remove the asterisk since this is a wildcard saying anything and everything. Replace it with exclamation point switch one. Fill out the username field if you want to restrict the use of this command to a single user, or tick any of the only allow options for groups. Save the button. Right-click the other button that switches to your second scene and select Edit Triggers. Plus, Chat, Twitch Chat, and put exclamation point switch dos in the message field. Dos is two in Spanish. Again, I'm just demonstrating that names and commands don't actually have to be strictly the same as the names of scenes and sources. Save the button, save the deck. Now you can test this by chatting in the chat doc in OBS if you have it. Or just go to your Twitch channel, go to chat, and type there. The beauty of this is that you don't have to be live to test this. The next videos will dive deeper into doing crazier stuff like toggling filters, creating your own alerts, randomizing properties, video sources, creating chatbots, browser sources, and accepting parameters. So please stay tuned for those. Thanks for watching.
また楽しいものを切ってしまいました。